Shalom, sisters. Most High in Christ bless. This is Sister Naomi from the House of Officers of Rubabel, Dallas, Texas camp. Welcome to our Sewing 101 tutorial.
Alrighty, so we're going through tools and terms that are just important to know when you're doing any type of sewing before we transition into talking about the sewing machine. So first, again, let's just reiterate a couple things that we talked about before. We'll start with the needle again. Remember a whole variety of shapes and sizes and purposes, but this is just a standard sewing, hand sewing needle. There also are needles that you buy for your machine. They are very specific to your machine type. Use your user manual to figure out which one goes with your machine. But that's needles in a nutshell. Okay, so here's threads again. Again, remember, threads come in different fabrics, different types, different lengths, different widths. There's different purposes. This is also called a thread. You can use this actually for all kinds of arts and crafts. Some people use them actually to sew if you want a wide seam that can actually be decorative. It's also used for embroidery. So there's tons of different types of thread, but I just want you to get the term down. Thread is what you use in the sewing environment.
Alrighty, so next term is a thimble. Thimble, again, is just to protect your fingertips. They come in different materials. Rubber, metal, and plastic are the most common. These are thimbles.
Here you have scissors. Scissors, again, different shapes, different purposes. Make sure you use them only on your fabric. Fabrics is the next term that we're talking about. Here I just have a couple of scrap fabrics that I've used in the past. Always know the type of fabric, the amount of fabric that you need. There's so many different varieties of fabrics. It also depends on the project that you're doing, but this is what they mean when they're saying you need a certain type of fabric. There's tons of different fabrics.
Alrighty, the next term is yards. When you go to a fabric store and you buy whatever the material is, a fabric, if you're buying fringes, if you're buying border blue, if you're just buying ribbon, whatever it is, everything is measured in yards when you go to the fabric store. So make sure you know how to convert your measurement, which is usually in inches, to yards, as follows.
Okay, so measuring tape is the next term. This is an example of measuring tape used most often. On one side you have inches, on the other side you have centimeters, and also inches. So whichever side is preferred by you, most of the time when we do measurements, we use the inches. We'll kind of go over that in detail later, but this is an example of measuring tape.
Okay, so yardstick is the next term, and this is an example of a yardstick. Again, yardstick is mostly used when you are measuring something flat because it's not pliable, so you can't actually move it or bend it. Usually comes in wood, and it's just good to measure length of something laying down.
These are an example of pins. They're used for marking and holding your fabric together. This is just an example. They come in tons of different shapes and sizes.
All right, the next term is marker or chalk. You want to have something to make marks on your fabric that is easily removable. So ask around in the fabric store or visit your local market just to find what is easiest for you to use.
These are some examples of bobbins. We'll go into a little more detail what they are and where they belong later on, but just so you know the term bobbin, this is what we're talking about when we say bobbin. This is an example of a seam ripper. A seam ripper is used to take any kind of seam that you might have already sewed and then you kind of changed your mind or made a mistake. This is made to kind of seam through or cut through the seam so that you can start over. You also hear the term raw edge. What that refers to the edge of the fabric that has already been cut. Again, usually it's any piece of fabric where it's cut and uneven and it's raw, so it's called the raw edge of the fabric. When we talk about casing, this would be a really basic example. If we were making a waistline and we needed to pull through some elastic on, let's say this is the top of the skirt, a casing would be anything where you created a seam and you've stitched all the way across and then you have an actual hole where you would slide in any kind of fabric or string, usually elastic. This is an example of some adhesive. There's all types of fabric adhesive, but this is one example of bonding tape. It's really easy to use, makes really, if you don't want to hand sew or you have something that doesn't need to be sewed completely, this is actually a piece of fabric on top, piece of fabric on the bottom. You press it with an iron and the heat melts it and it creates an adhesive, which is bonding the two fabrics or two pieces of the fabric together. These are some examples of binding. Binding is when you have a raw edge and you don't want it to show, so you use the bonding to actually cover that raw edge. So for example, this shirt, if we wanted to create a really smooth line and cover it with another color or in any kind of fabric, you can actually buy the binding already made and you just sew it on. There's a whole technique to it, but just so if you ever hear the word binding, it's usually this type of material that you can actually create a really smooth edge with. This is an example of some patterns. When you hear the word patterns, they mean you actually going and buying them, or you can create a pattern, but these are examples of store-bought patterns. I mean, it has everything, every detail you need, from what type of fabric to buy, how much fabric, any accessories you might need. It's all included in here, and it also has these sheets inside, and the sheets are actually exact cutouts of each piece that you would have to create from each fabric. So it's pretty dummy proof, really simple, tedious, but it gets the job done and it makes sure that whatever your project is, it's done to the exact measurement as possible.